Now, saturated and unsaturated compound. A saturated compound has a chain of carbon linked with single bond. These compounds are normally not very reactive. Now, very common example of a saturated compound is ethane. So, ethane has a molecular formula of C2H6. So, now if you see in the diagram given over here, it has two carbon atoms. So, we'll be drawing one, two. These are given by single bond. And then there are six hydrogen atoms. So, three hydrogen atoms each carbon. And that is exactly that is shown in the diagram over here, which is an electronic dot structure. I've got two carbon atoms and they are sharing one electron each. And then each carbon atom is sharing one electron with one molecule of hydrogen. So the molecular formula is C2H6. Now there's another example called as propane. Let us try drawing propane molecule. Now propane has three carbons, so they are linked by single bond. And then it has eight atoms of hydrogen. So all these gaps will be filled by hydrogen atom. So carbon is sharing one electron each with one carbon atom and then one atom with another hydrogen atom. So the molecular formula is C3H8. Now the next is unsaturated compound. So unsaturated compound have double or triple bond in them. And one of the most popular example is ethene. But one thing you need to keep in mind that the double and the triple bond are more reactive than the single bond. So it's going to be more reactive than the saturated compound. So if you see in the diagram over here, the carbon is sharing two electrons each. So that is why it has double bond. If it shares one electron each, then it's going to be a single bond. If it is sharing two electrons each, then it is going to be a double bond. And if it is sharing three electrons each, then it is going to be a triple bond. So ethene is an example of a double bond compound. And then there is another example called as ethyne. Now how will you draw ethyne? Ethyne has two carbon. So one, two, and it just has two hydrogen. So hydrogen can be only by single bond because hydrogen has just one atom. And we know that carbon needs four atoms to satisfy its valence shell. So what we'll be doing, this is one, two, three, and four. So that is why it is a triple bond and hence it is an unsaturated carbon compound. Next, let us learn about chains, branches, and rings. Now, carbon compounds like methane, ethane, propane, which are unsaturated compounds, are 1, 2, 3 carbons. Now, such chains of carbon can contain up to 10 carbon atoms. So these are just the single chain which can have up to 10 carbon atoms. But let us take another look at a butane. If we make the carbon skeleton with 4 carbon atoms, we see that it has 2 kinds of structure. Now the molecular formula of butane is C4H10. So if we try drawing butane compound, we can either do it by this way or it has another possibility of this compound. Fill up the valence shell, we get 1 and two possible ways of drawing a butane compound. Now we see that both of these formula have C4H10. It has 4 carbon atoms and 10 hydrogen atoms. So such compounds which have identical molecular formula but they have different structures are called as a structural isomers. That is, their formula is going to remain the same but they have two different structures and this is called as a structural isomer. Now next compound is a cyclohexane. So if you see a cyclohexane compound, the molecular formula of cyclohexane is C6H12. So you can make a cyclohexane in a cyclic form. So this is going to be the skeleton and once you fill the hydrogen, the last structural formula will be this one. And if you see in case of benzene, benzene has a molecular formula of C6H6. So it is an unsaturated compound because it has double bond and it is cyclic in nature. So all of these carbon compounds which contain just carbon and hydrogen are called as the hydrocarbon. Why? Because it has just hydrogen and carbon. And the saturated are called as alkanes. So So these compounds, saturated is one bond, and these are called as alkenes. And in unsaturated, if it has double bond, it is called as alkenes. And if it has triple bond, it is called as alkynes. So it is alkanes, alkenes, and alkynes. Next is functional group. Now carbon, we have seen that it is present everywhere in the universe, and there are a lot of different forms of carbon which are available. So carbon seems to be a very friendly element. It forms bonds with other elements like halogen, oxygen, nitrogen, and sulfur. In a hydrocarbon chain, one or more hydrogen can be replaced by these elements such that the valency of carbon remains satisfied. So instead of adding hydrogen to the molecule, I can add any other element as well, provided that the valency of the carbon gets satisfied. Now in such compounds, the elements replacing hydrogen is referred to as a heteroatom. So if a hydrogen has been replaced by any other atom, it is called as a heteroatom. And these heteroatoms have specific properties to the compound, regardless to the length and nature of the carbon chain, and hence it is called as a functional group. So the table shown over here, these are all the functional group, and depending upon the functional group, the nature of the carbon is going to stay. So we saw a hydrocarbon wherein a carbon and a hydrogen is present. So if I remove one hydrogen and add any other atom to it, like a functional group, the entire property of the carbon is going to change. So the functional group over here are halo, which has Cl or Br. So I will be substituting the hydrogen atom with Cl or Br, that is chlorine or bromine. Next is alcohol. So this is how alcohol is denoted. So instead of replacing H, I will be writing OH. So it becomes an alcohol group. Next is aldehyde. So this is the molecular formula of aldehyde, and it's a functional group. So I can replace H with aldehyde. The third one is a ketone. So this is a ketone functional group, and I can replace one hydrogen and add this as a functional group. The fourth one is carboxylic acid. So this is the carboxylic acid, and I can replace one hydrogen and add a carboxylic acid to it. So my entire property of the compound is going to change just by one functional group.